Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. I'm Dr. Mohammad Zubair and you are watching Research in Political Science. This is our first video in the series on research methods in political science, public administration, public policy and international relations. This video is very important because this will provide basis for the entire course on research methods. In this video, I'm going to tell you what is research from practical perspective. What are the different definitions of research? What are the different types of research? What is the true nature of research? And what are the different steps involved in the research process? Whenever we hear the term research, what comes to mind is professionals, professors, researchers. However, it is only partly true. Research is also part and parcel of our daily life. हम अपनी रोजमर्रा जिंदगी में भी वन वे और अनदर वी डू कंडक्ट रिसर्च. थिंक व्हाट डिड योर पेरेंट्स डू व्हेन दे मेड डिसीजन अबाउट योर एजुकेशन. आमतौर पर वालदेन क्या करते हैं, वो अपनी फैमिली एंड फ्रेंड्स में बच्चों को देखते हैं कि किसके बच्चे ने क्या तालीम हासिल की और हाउ ही आर शी इज डूइंग इन द प्रैक्टिकल लाइफ. आफ्टर डूइंग दिस काइंड ऑफ सर्वे फिर क्या करेंगे, फिर वो किसी प्रोफेसर के पास, किसी सीनियर के पास, किसी प्रोफेशनल के पास जाएंगे और उनसे जाकर मशवरा कर लेंगे. आफ्टर डूइंग ऑल दीज थिंग्स देन दे मेक ए डिसीजन अबाउट द एजुकेशन ऑफ देयर चाइल्ड. सो व्हाट डिड दे डू एक्चुअली, दैट वाज एन इनफॉर्मल रिसर्च. सो रिसर्च इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ इन्वेस्टिगेशन इन ऑर्डर टू रिजॉल्व आवर प्रॉब्लम. जनरली रिसर्च इज based on our existing knowledge. It's the journey from known to unknown. That is why the word research itself says research. We build on our existing knowledge. देखिए, अभी जो मिसाल मैंने आपको दी उसमें क्या हुआ, पेरेंट्स ने क्या किया, कुछ मालूमात इकट्ठी की, फैक्ट्स एंड फिगर्स. इन द लैंग्वेज ऑफ रिसर्च फैक्ट्स एंड फिगर्स आर नोन एज डेटा. वो जो इकट्ठा किया गया है फैक्ट्स एंड फिगर्स, दैट इज डेटा कलेक्शन. वंस ए रीजनेबल अमाउंट ऑफ डेटा हैज बीन कलेक्टेड देन इट इज प्रोसेस्ड एनालिसिस. सो वी कैन से रिसर्च इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ डेटा कलेक्शन एंड डेटा एनालिसिस इन ऑर्डर टू प्रोवाइड आंसर्स टू आवर क्वेश्चंस. हाउएवर द इशू इज, अगर वाकई रिसर्च इतनी सादा और सिंपल चीज है तो फिर मसला क्या होगा. मसला ये होगा कि आपने अपने मामले को, मसले को हल करने के लिए कोई फैसला किया, तो फिर अगर वो वाकई रिसर्च है तो फिर सबको आपके ही फैसले पर अमल करना चाहिए. हाउएवर इट इज नॉट द केस. योर डिसीजन अबाउट एनी प्रॉब्लम इज ओनली योर्स डिसीजन. इट इज इनफॉर्मल रिसर्च. नाउ इन ऑर्डर टू मेक योर डिसीजन, योर फाइंडिंग, योर नॉलेज वर्थवाइल, एक्सेप्टेबल फॉर एवरीवन, यू नीड टू डू साइंटिफिक रिसर्च. So there is another thing, scientific research. Now look at the term scientific. When we say science is the knowledge acquired through observations and experiments. And when we say scientific, the term scientific means that any activity, any process which has been conducted, completed by adopting certain procedures and steps. So science means something done systematically. So we can define scientific research as research is a scientific inquiry that is conducted by adopting certain principles and applying certain techniques and steps or procedures in order to generate fresh knowledge. Only then such a research will be acceptable to everyone. That is scientific research. When we say scientific research, it means it is based on science, observation, experiments. It is not based on my free will, my liking, disliking. So the true nature of scientific research is that it is verifiable. Anyone can verify what I have concluded. Anyone can verify the accuracy of your research. If it is scientific research, it is not based on your liking and disliking. So verifiability, accuracy, testability, replicability, these things reflect the true nature of scientific research. Now when we say research in political science, our focus revolves around three things. individual as a citizen, as a worker, as a consumer, individual, the life of individual, the issues that he or she faces, society, civil society, the problems within society, and state, governance. So, generally speaking, these three spheres of research are available to the students and researchers in political science. Now, we can conduct research on issues like how the state is actually existing in the 21st century. We are more concerned about issues of governance in today's life.
Electoral politics, accountability, trust, transparency, political instability, law and order issues,
poverty, human rights abuses, all of these things, some one way or another, are connected with the issues of governance. So there is a lot of space for conducting research in political science. Now, the types of research in political science. There are two types of research in political science, public administration and public policy. One we call applied research and the other is basic research. When we say applied research, this research is practical in nature. This is such a research which is meant to resolve a very particular problem. So actually the findings of the research are supposed to resolve a certain problem. And when we say pure research is meant to enhance our understanding of the subject. It is meant to add to the existing body of the subject, development of theories. Let me give you an example of applied research in political science. A political scientist wants to understand why there remained a low turnout in the general election in a particular constituency. If he or she is able to investigate and bring out the causes, dynamics of the low turnout, then the election commission of that state or the government, political parties, all of these stakeholders can involve themselves and rectify those causes so that in the next election there will be fair or high turnout. So there are several examples. Similarly, a public policy can be examined. A researcher evaluates a particular public policy. The purpose is to revisit the policy, bring forth its weaknesses, shortcomings, so that the government can redesign that policy in a manner that really facilitates the masses. Now, in the last section, I will tell you what are the different steps involved in research process. There are four steps involved in research process. The first is topic selection, second, data collection, third, data analysis, and fourth, report writing. So these are the four steps involved in research process. And in our coming videos, we will go into the details of each and every step involved in the research process. Our next video will be on topic selection. Topic selection is extremely important part of the research process. If you are able to select your topic rightly, correctly, I will say, then you will be in a position to complete it right in time. So that is very important, and students or beginners always feel extremely confused and disturbed on this stage. So please don't forget to watch the next video, and I will also request you to subscribe to this channel and press the bell icon. Please share your comments, your thoughts about research, about the various issues of research that you are dealing with. What are the problems that you are facing? For example, in this topic, if you had any query, you must write it in the comment sections, and I will personally try to respond to your comments. Keeping in view your comments, we will be able to further improve our videos. Looking forward for your subscription, your participation through comments, your likes. See you in the next video. Allah Hafiz.